Hello and welcome everybody to the Brett Norman YouTube channel on this Sunday, March 22nd, 2020. I'm joined here with Michael in Germany. Michael, welcome. Thank you for putting together this document. I'm ready to go.
Hello, Brett, and hello, dear listener. Thanks for having me. This is another episode of the Satanic Media Exposed, which is a collaboration between Brett and me. And actually, it's a collaboration which we are doing as Bible-believing Christians with the source of the King James Version 1611. And we will take care of the character, of the artificial character David Bowie. And we are on the next episode now, and I'm going into this subject because David Bowie is on the outside is a singer, but actually he's also another puppet of Satan, spreading these lies, spreading this agenda out there. And people think that he was a genius, whatever, but you see that he just was being used by Satan and his fallen angels. That's the case for all the artists who are not praising God, and they do that big scale. And there's no difference if there is an actor or a writer or an author or a singer or a dancer, whatever. All people who are successful must be on the broad way, according to Matthew chapter 7, and therefore they have to serve Satan.
Comment. I've got a comment, Michael. You mentioned that these actors, if we call them that, these puppets for Satan, are secular. They're not Christian. Well, you know, there is Christian music as well, but you know, the problem with the Christian music is it mainly promotes ecumenism, which is, you know, we should all come together and be good Christians together, you know, regardless of what flavor or doctrine you worship. You know, this is the wrong way, the wrong way. And, you know, whether it be secular music or quote unquote Christian music, we should always take it down to the root level, do the research before we really put our heart into it, you know, because when it comes down to it, you know, I'm a musician, Michael. You've been involved with music too, Michael. And we know that it's very important to the spirit of mankind to have good music. And we're not saying all music is bad. No, it's music that is being used by Satan to promote the earthly agenda, or under the guise of Christianity, actually, to promote the ecumenical agenda. It's the same thing, really. When you get down to it, these different mottos of the Jesuits, you have the end justifies the means. You have also the Catholic motto. I don't know the Latin phrase off the top of my head, but it's something like ad morium de gloriam, to the greater glory of God, or something.
Yeah. Ad majorem del gloria, I think.
Thank you. See, that's a little bit more than I can retain in this brain of mine.
I'm not speaking of the Christian music, because I was speaking actually for the very successful music. And to be successful, you must be, you must make music which pleasure, where the masses have pleasure in listening to. Yeah. And that's the condition. Yeah. So otherwise you won't be successful. You like to sell many copies. You like to sell many records. So therefore you must make music for the masses. And the mass is anti-Christian, because it's mentioned in the Bible that it's the broad way which leads to destruction. And the broad way is the broad way because many people have to take place there. So it's quite logical, in my opinion, that the Broadway is the road which leads to destruction, because the most of the people are not in the Christian spirit, in the spirit of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. And this is just another example with David Bowie here. Look at the picture here. It's his thin white Duke face, 1976. This was the face where he contacted the white witch Wally Ermelak, when he did many things on drugs, for example, cocaine, and when he was losing weight, big scale. I have read something about that he weighed about 100 pounds there. 100 pounds. I don't know his exact height, but you see that it's just not that big thing now. The big thing is that if you don't mind, I would like to make it through the script now. You see, it is mentioned here in Mark Spitz Bowie, a biography from 2020, that Bowie was obsessed with the occult magic to attain success and to protect himself from demonic forces. We know the second item mentioned here, but the first is, you see, he's using magic to attain success. And that's the thing. They have to be creative. They have to have inspiration from the so-called other side to be successful, to make music for the masses. That's exactly the point, which I was pointing to in the beginning. And so you see that you have it from several sources here. And going to the script, you see that it's sometimes nitty-gritty of it. Yeah, there's a man called Hughes here that David had a fear of height, and it's not that the big things which I'm interested in. I'm interested in the little details, which then you get a picture, the picture of someone's spirit, because you know that we can measure them by the fruits. Yeah, so you see that. We learned that he had some problems with cocaine, that he got in touch with the so-called white witch, and there is no white witch. A witch is a witch is a witch. Which witch is which? No, there is not no kind of a witch which is white, because all sorcery, witchcraft is forbidden in the Bible. So, but there is another thing, because Bowie took care of himself. At least he thought he could. Bowie became obsessed with the book Psychic Self-Defense by the author. You see, author who are successful have to please Satan, have to spread also the Satan media agenda, because also the book is a medium to spread any kind of propaganda. And this is a book called Psychic Self-Defense by Dion Fortune. Look at this. This is the author, Dion Fortune, Psychic Self-Defense. Oh, you got 4.4 pentagrams out of 5. Yeah, this is from Amazon. Amazon, where furious women who were fighting, they were called Amazons. But you see that all today, which is about purchasing merchandise, having success, earning money big scale, has been valued by pentagrams, 5-pointed stars. Oh, it must be a coincidence. So, who's Dion Fortune? Where that's a woman, and the book where David Bowie relied on in the first place. So, this is not her real name. Yeah, she actually is called Violette Mary Firth. Yeah, 1890, born in Wales, speaking of Great Britain, and died on 1946. She was a I'm sorry, this is German now. She was an occultist, a Rosicrucian, a theosophical, and an author, writer. Yeah, she was the founder of the Fraternity of the Inner Light, which is called today Society of the Inner Light. Yeah, problem is now, this is her so-called alias. Yeah, this is not her birth name, Dion Fortune. Fortune comes from Fortuna, Latin, and means the goddess of luck, yeah? Fate, Fox Fortuna, the power of fate. Yeah? This is from the Roman mythology. Yeah? So she is giving herself a name like a Roman goddess. Great, huh? Great from the start. This is Fortune, and there's a famous classical song called from Karl Orff, from Carmina Burana, which is very prominent for sport events, because there is a choir and it's a very dramatic thing, and it sounds absolutely not positive in no way at all. Yeah. So Fortune is the ruler of the world. All, yeah, the master, the female master of the world. Yeah. But you see, that's not the thing. Yeah. The thing is, the people think that nowadays, oh, this stuff is ancient, it's medieval, it has any, not in any kind or shape or form, any relation to 2020. This is the name of two German soccer clubs, Fortuna 95 and Fortuna Cologne. Got it? It's 2020, folks. and the name Fortuna or Fortune has been named, has been used for several clubs, especially in sport. And you know this word, unfortunately, meaning positive. I'm not pointing out it's the UN Fortuna television.
No, no, the telly. The
yeah,
telly.
The telly. Yeah, the telly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. People talk about the telly all the time.
Yeah, actually, really, this is a joke which springs up into my mind in an instant now. Yeah, you see, that this was not staged or planned or written before, but it's just about the name Fortuna, which is in the word unfortunately. Yeah, but you don't pronounce it Fortuna. You pronounce it unfortunately, Fortuna. Huh? Okay, you see, take care of the words, take care of the phrases, take care of your language, and you will reveal so many things by simply examining what kind of words, what kind of language you are using, and where the origin is coming from. And I find that really interesting. Yeah, yeah. That is all. This is
Michael.
Yeah.
Do you have the chat on the right side open?
No.
Oh, that's me. Never mind. I'm sorry I interrupt.
No, no, no problem. I don't know. I have here the PDF now in the biggest
good,
scale
good.
I can.
I'm sorry.
So that
I was just a little bit nervous there.
Yeah,
because,
you don't have to be concerned.
I don't want personal information getting out on the internet.
No. Nothing to worry about, really.
I mean, a little here, a little there. Yeah, it goes. But, you know, sorry.
Okay, no problem. So who's the so-called Dion Fortune? You know that Dio means God. She calls herself God. Yeah, Dion Fortune. Fortune is Fortuna, is the Roman goddess of fortune, of fate. And Dio, take the musician Ronnie James Dio, who was supposedly the one who said that he introduced the devil horn sign, the hand sign, in the hard rock by being a member of Black Sabbath. Yeah, his name is Ronnie James Dio, but Dio is his artist name, so he calls himself God. I'm not making it up. It's really the case. So this Dion Fortier was a theosophical person and a Rosicrucian. Yeah, and 1919, she was a member of the Alpha et Omega Temple in Edinburgh, the successor of the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn. Huh? This is the same thing, which I explained in the German lecture of Kate Bush. Yeah, all these Rosicrucian. Rosicrucian, for example, the Christian Rosenkreuz, yeah, which is supposedly founder of the Rosicrucian order, in my opinion, has never existed. Yeah, it's just a mockery. Yeah, they are making that up. Yeah, you see the rose here in the circle in between. Yeah, this is the centerpiece here. It's a rose consisting of five. I think it's called petals. Huh? Is it right? Correct?
Oh
right.
Yeah, petals of a flower.
Okay.
Sure,
petals. Yeah. Yeah, and nothing of it here is really positive or nice or whatever. There are no Christian symbols, especially there is, in my opinion, there is an error here in that symbol, but I cannot tell you now what and when, because then we never finish about David Bowie. But you see, that's just the thing that, of course, he relied on this book, Psychic Self-Defense. There is no self-defense from a mortal man because they are mortal. So there is no psychic self-defense from a material being to a spirit. It's not possible, because the spirit is much more intelligent, wiser, and it lives far more longer, has more experience, and you cannot fight against, there are no material weapons against a spiritual being. That's the thing which I always point out in the German sessions. There is no crucifix, no Rosicrucian, whatever, nothing. No herbals, no rituals, no pentagrams. It's all BS. Oh, you see, I learn to
good.
use American language properly. Huh?
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome.
Yeah, it's good.
So, because of her publication of the book Sane Occultism and Psychic Self-Defense, mm-hmm. They claim that she was throwing out inner secrets, and she was condemned for that. Huh? And she said this was channeled material. So that was given to her by channeling. Huh? That's to get in touch with the dead spirits or spirits, whatever. And she said she was in contact with several masters of wisdom. Yeah, and this is the same thing which happens to Madame Blavatsky, Edgar Cayce, and Aleister Crowley. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you see, that's the same thing around, and I don't want to spoil the mood for some of your listeners now, Brad, but in my humble opinion, it's the same as Ellen G. White.
Oh, sure. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but nevertheless, although she was channeling with demons, she was a member of the Science, Arts, and Crafts Society. and as I pointed out, she founded her own organization, the Fraternity of the Inner Light, la 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 la. No? I'm not using blah, 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 but la 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 la. Yeah, at 1939, October, when the Second World War was running, there were some light works on the astral works to protect England in general. Yeah, they did light work. Yeah, work for the light on the astral, in the astral universe to protect England from the World War. You see what kind of people these are. Yeah, what they think they got such extreme power that they can protect a whole country. Yeah, you can imagine that they are not having a small kind of self-esteem. Yeah, she died in a year with 55 years and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And this is a chapter of the book, Psychic, I hope it's correct.
Right, that's correct.
Oh, it seems a little bit weird here in German. Chapter 5, Vampirism. And then, you know, when there's a chapter of how to protect yourself against vampires, yeah, you can throw the book into your chimney.
Yep.
At least that's good for that. Yeah. Yeah, you can. So, you know, that this is page 25 of that book, Vampirism. Okay, we can scroll. Yeah. She's advising you, in pointing or making the sign of the cross, the first and the second fingers are extended, and the third and fear and blah, blah, blah. Yeah. So they're using a pagan symbolism of the cross. It's no, the cross is no Christian symbol. And they're, of course, speaking of God. Yeah. Which God? The God maybe which is imprinted on the backside of the $1 bill?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Right. Ah, okay. Yeah. How he now proceeds to draw the magic circle upon the floor with the point of the sword of power, blah, 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 blah. There is no material protection against the spiritual being. End of discussion. It has never worked. It will never work. Yeah. Imagine the contradiction.
Yes, it's all principality, Michael.
Yeah, I mean, imagine the contradiction, Brad. Yeah, if he would show the symbol of the Church of Satan with the horns of Baphomet, yeah, mm-hmm. with the five-pointed star pointing downwards, it's a symbol mm-hmm. of Satanism. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and they And it is claimed that the symbol then in opposition, so that the five-pointed star is moving upwards, is a symbol of protection. Now, it's, now I really don't know if you know that, but that's just my explanation of that.
Well, right. It's Luciferianism versus Satanism. They're both bad. Just chuck the whole thing, like you said, in the chimney. Burn it. Get it out.
It's a blatant lie. It's a blatant lie, and I tell you why. I tell you why in an instant. This is the Church of Satan. I'm looking for a particular picture. I hope I find it now. Imagine this would be the Church of Satan symbol, which is the opposite. So it's now, this is Luciferian. It has been told us so. Yeah, this is a black candle for black magic, of course. Yeah. So, and the star is pointing upwards. Yeah. So, now in the Church of Satan, this symbol here, the five-pointed stars, yeah, is in opposition. So the star is pointing downwards. It is on the floor of a church, or hanging on a wall. So now imagine you cross the floor to the altar. And you're coming back. Then what? Then you're facing that symbol in the opposite direction. And now? You see, you think you can switch around the symbol and have another meaning? Are you really that manipulated? Are you really that manipulated? Can you expect then when Satan and his fallen angels are spirits, they are not bound to a material body, to a mortal body? Okay, if I use that symbol, I am protect. I have to switch the symbol around, yeah, and then I'm protected. Can you tell how the spirits will laugh at you? Will laugh at you. They have no form. These are spirits. Don't you know they can turn around, they can fly through the air? Satan is called the prince of the power of the air. You think he cannot switch the side? So all is futile and all is misinformation. For example, Goethe's Faust, where he then drew this pentagram as a protection circle on the floor, and then Mephistopheles could not go out. Yeah, this is all misinformation. Goethe, sorry to say, has absolutely no clue or is a misinformation agent. It's up to you to decide. I'm really sorry, but I have to point that out. It's so laughable, actually. There are no protection symbols. So this psychic self-defense is garbage. Okay, moving on. Yeah, garbage, trash can. Yeah, I made use of the pentagram, blah, blah, blah. Certain names of power. Moving on. Yeah, so. In 1919, she joined an occult order run by Theodore Moriarty. Oh, there rang a bell. Moriarty? Are you, Brett, in any kind, shape, or form familiar with Sherlock Holmes?
Sure.
Who's the arch enemy of Sherlock Holmes?
Okay, I forget now.
It's not, it's really not hard, I will tell you.
Please.
It's Professor Moriarty.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really. And for the old series, for the old books by Sir Conan Doyle, as well as for the television series of the BBC, running from 2014 or 15. So Moriarty, Mordor, means murder. We have that. We discussed that on Moribund, the Bürgermeister, on the Peter Gabriel lectures. Okay, so according to the book, yeah, Bowie began drawing protective pentagrams on every surface. You now know that it's absolutely futile, and this is the comedy section here. He was on the edge all the time of paranoia. Yeah, we know also that. So, the girl named Cherry Vanilla verified the connection between Bowie and the White Witch. Also that we know. So moving on. Yeah. Robert Fripp, we also know. Moving on. And this Wally Emlock talked to DJ Jeff Dexter about cosmic children, spirits from other places who take physical forms, such as Hendrix, Boland, Bowie, and Mike Ribbons, the drummer of Badfinger. Robert Fripp stated, the function on the album is to reach out to the children, like the drummer from Badfinger. I want to say, you're not nutty, you're not a freak, because you can't relate to what's around you. Yeah. So their mission is to entertain the children. So to enter and tame the mental state of children. That's the reason why Robert Fripp got in connection with the White Witch. Okay, moving on. This is one guy I found who made a claim that he had a relationship with her. You see, this is the White Witch with the black hair and the black dress and the black eyes and so on. I lived with her on the 65th Street for 2 years. She was my one older woman relationship. I answered the phone when David, speaking of David Bowie, and Angie Bowie called from LA after she had given instructions to them. We, speaking of Wally Elmlock, Carol, this is the girl from the radio interview, and myself, sat in a circle around the large pentagram on the floor and her foyer, and we did the very same spell at the same time for his protection. At daybreak the very next morning, 5 to 6 p.m., East Standard Time, this cannot be, it must be 5 to 6 a.m. actually, according to my knowledge of the time code in the United States. While listening to the morning newscast, they announced that David has quietly admitted himself into the care of a psych ward in L.A., the name of which I no longer remember. If memory serves, it was within days of his co-appearance alongside Mrs. Aretha Franklin behind the days of that year's Grammy Awards ceremony. Yeah, so this is makes sense, no? To sit in a circle around a large pentagram and making spells to protect someone from the eel. Yeah? So you see that also this White Witch has absolutely no clue and is indoctrinated and is spoiling the mental state of David Bowie. Okay, moving on, because this is the German phrase. Yeah. Where I pointed out that in Matthew 12, Jesus Christ said it will happen after according to your faith. And if you believe in witchcraft, if you believe in evil spirits, if you believe in sorcery, then these things will happen according to your belief. Because you are allowing these spirits to enter your mind, to enter and to attain your mental state. This is what's entertainment all about. It is all about. It's quite simple. It's so simple. It's so simple. Yeah. Jesus Christ said here in John 8:12, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in the darkness, but shall have the light of life. And in John 1:5, it has been said that the light is glowing in the darkness, but the darkness has not. Could you help me out here in the King James Bible, Brett?
Yeah. I'm sorry. Which chapter verse?
John 1:5.
John 1:5. Yeah, let me look it up here for you. Just gotta fire up my old E sword. John 1:5. Here we go. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehend it not.
Yeah, that's it. So that when you're speaking to someone who is in the darkness because he does not have the light, he does not have the faith in Jesus Christ, in Jesus Christ, yeah, then he cannot comprehend what you are talking about. Then he doesn't comprehend what we are talking about here. So in the case that you absolutely agree and you know what we are talking about here, it is a very good indication that you are in the Holy Spirit, because you know then that Jesus Christ is the light of the world and not Lucifer, who was the light bearer. You see, there is actually a very big difference between the light and the light bearer. The one is the source and the other is the servant, or the one is the master and the other is the servant. It's really important to get the facts straight. Now, all these Freemasons and all these Rosicrucians and all these orders, may it be Catholic or Asian or Protestant or Freemason and whatever, they're trying to convince you that Lucifer is the source of wisdom and is the light and is the wise serpent, etc., etc. It is a created being. He is not the source. He is a created being. Okay, let's move on. Yeah, and you see here in the Genesis 3:13, yeah, and the woman said, speaking of Eve, of course, the serpent beguiled me and I did eat. Beguiled me, it is mentioned in the Esau, Hebrews 5:3-7:7. 5:3-7:7, nasha, a primitive root to lead astray. Mentally to delude, morally to seduce, beguile, deceive, greatly, utterly. Where does magic come from? The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. In my humble opinion, and to my knowledge at that point, all this so-called magic comes from Satan himself in various disguises under various names. Magic, sorcery, witchcraft, paganism, Wicca, shamanism, whatever. Okay. This is from a Hebrew dictionary. H5172, Nashash. Yeah? Let's compare it. Nashash, a snake from its hiss, serpent. 5172, 5175. Let's compare it again. 5172, Nashash, a primitive root properly to hiss that is whisper a magic spell. Generally, to prognosticate, certainly divine enchanter. Enchantment, learn by experience, indeed, diligent, observe. Nashash. This is the source of magic. So, meaning that every magic, may it be with C or with CK to indicate that this magic originated from the author of the Golden Dawn or OTO from Aleister Crowley, with the K, which is the 11th letter of the alphabet, having a certain meaning for the Freemasonry, comes from Satan under the disguise of the serpent. I think that's important information, I hope.
I have 1839 Webster's Dictionary definition of prognosticate: to foreshadow, to indicate a future event by present signs, to foretell by means of present signs, to predict.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, all kinds of prophecy, all kinds of fortune tellers, all kinds of foretellers. Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Yeah, thank you, Michael. This is an interesting study, all right.
Yeah, I hope so.
Oh, yes, it is.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, this is a Genesius Hebrew Chaldee lexicon. Yeah. To hiss, to whisper. Yeah, you see that's the same indication here. H5172. We can agree on that. Yeah. It's to hiss, to whisper, special use of the whispering of soothsayers. To practice enchantment towards sorcery. IQ Arabic, I cannot read that actually. And here are the biblical references. Of course, the Strong's number H5172. Okay? Divination by serpents. As if it were denomination from CCC2 and so on and so on. You can look that up for yourself. It's not that hard. But you see, there are actually, now you got the window of opportunity where you can look up several dictionaries, as Brett now live did. You can do the same by doing it online afterwards. Okay? Yeah, and the man took as an omen. Okay, you see, now I don't like to mix so many languages up. It's like it's just only to have a feeling for the several explanations of the serpent who beguiled Eve. And this was the first lie. The first lie was being made prominent. And then actually, said to Eve, to the first woman, and led to the downfall of mankind, or downfall of man. Sorcery. Maybe the snake had a human voice. We don't know that. The Bible does not reveal that. And I would take absolutely anything to warn you to look anywhere else beside the King James Bible. There are so many forgeries out there. There are so many ancient historians. There are so many apocryphic books, the Book of Enoch, the Talmud, etc. You will have then 10, 11, 12, 20, 50 different explanations, and you're running around in a circle whatever. Yeah, you're never coming to the truth. Yeah, but the truth, according to the Bible, is that the serpent beguiled Eve. And the serpent is just another mask, another disguise of Satan. And if David Bowie is pointing something out in his song, he's also another disguise of Satan, because he's serving the same agenda. The purpose of the Satanic Media Agenda actually is to portray or to reveal, according to Ephesians 5:11, to reveal the unfruitful works of the darkness. All these images, all these characters, all these actors are actually disguises of Satan. Satan is a spirit. And if a spirit enters a human body, then the human singer, dancer, whatever, take Beyoncé, alter ego, Sasha Fierce, for example, yeah, then she's the mouthpiece of Satan when she's on stage. It's actually that simple. Okay, moving on. Yeah, this is a connection between Wally Almlack and Jimi Hendrix. You see, all the people where Wally Almlack got in touch with, have they led a Christian life? Have they led a happy life? You know,
no, they led others into adultery, fornication, witchcraft, sorcery.
Yeah.
On and on and on and on. Wicked stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, just listen to the lyrics of Jimi Hendrix, right?
Yeah. Voodoo child.
Yeah. Right.
Voodoo child. Yeah. I'm standing up next to a mountain. You see, maybe it's a mountain or a hill where Kate Bush is running up that hill to make a deal with God and to switch the places. Or it is a Salisbury Hill. Mm-hmm. It is always the same code words. It's a mountain. It's a place of a higher being. It's called a mountain or a hill, for example. It's like putting out the other side. Always it's meant the dark side. Always it's meant, the shadows or Satan and his followers. No, it's always the same. Actually, it's no big deal. Yeah, because I'm a voodoo child. Lord knows who's Lord, maybe the Dark Lord. Lord knows I'm a voodoo child. This is the actual content of the lyric of Voodoo Child of Jimi Hendrix. And he was in touch with Wally Almlack, the so-called White Witch of New York. Lord knows I'm a voodoo child. You remember that picture, Brett?
Yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, Lord, Dark Lord, Devil, Satan. Yes, from Miami Vice.
Yeah, In the Air Tonight, Phil Collins. Yeah. It's the same. They are not mentioning Almighty Lord. They are just mentioning Lord. And Lord is not copyrighted. We have found out that in our XXL version of In the Air Tonight.
That's right.
This was really a tough session with 2 hours and 40 minutes something.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Almost 3 hours. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, because I'm a voodoo child. Lord knows I'm a voodoo child. Quasi ditz du mu. That's he was in touch with Jimi Hendrix, quoted in Excuse Me While I Kiss the Sky by David Henderson on page 251, says about Jimi Hendrix that many of the signature rhythms Jimi Hendrix played on guitar were very often the same rhythms that his father played in voodoo ceremonies. It's not called Voodoo Child by accident. I hope that's valuable information. This is coming from a documentary which I found, which is called Hell's Bells. These are 8 episodes. I found that documentary very helpful, but some of the things I'm not going, I would not
recommend.
But that was very useful for that stuff here for the script.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah. So we are going now back into New York, 1976, where people then and now claim, oh, see, this is quite usual. Things then, 1976, which were hidden or not in the real open and had to be ordered somewhere, whatever, are being made public in the open. So this is just a usual forum of witchcraft, and this is reddit.com of the occult, a collage which I made from tarot cards. How do you like that? Oh, here is the death, the emperor, the tower, the sun, pentacles, and so on. And people think this is funny. People think this is funny. Or people are building their own altars.
Mm-hmm.
People, this is Reddit. This is no occult site. This is not darknet or whatever. This is in the open. People are making the heck out of it and using all the symbolism. Yeah, and they're comparing it, and you can have first secret. Am I doing it right? Yeah, you see, it does not. It isn't important if you do it this way or that way. You're committing yourself to the evil side.
Mm-hmm.
That's that people don't get it. It's your mindset, it's your faith which counts, not the things which are your writing this or left or right or what. It's your faith. It's your faith in Jesus Christ.
Yep, faith. F-A-I-T-H. Yeah.
Correct. Yeah. Yeah. You see, it's really getting weird, and you see, this is a mirror here. Do you remember the picture of the T-Rex boss Mark Bolan sitting in front of a mirror with his hands praying? Yeah, you see where the mirror is the connection to the other side, and the mirror shows the other side in opposite direction. Okay. Yeah, this is all futile and all wrong information. There are no Akashic records. Yeah, this is all futile. This is all false in indications. I know that because my teacher was very deep into Tibet and India and all this stuff 25 to 30 years ago. He was a famous writer of books. He has published about 40 books on astrology alone. And he was a medical student and this. And I thought in 1998, when I met him, he was a very smart guy, and he died at the age of 50. Okay, but it's not that important now. But you see, this is all philosopher's stone, blah blah la la la. This is all futile BS. Oh, just
you caught
it.
Yourself.
Cool. Last
good minute. Job, Michael. Good job.
Bull BS. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The problem is now these things are going deep into the into public appearance by spreading the word, spreading this kind of ceremonies on YouTube, Reddit, etc., so that everybody doesn't need any kind of book, just internet connection to get in touch with the dark side. Great, huh? Yeah. This has all been prophesied in the book of Revelation in the last days. Yeah, and you see, this is also a book for children, the little demon recommender. Yeah, little demon. Oh, oh, this is great. Yeah.
Yeah.
And people say, oh, yeah, this is a recommendation. And yeah, this is a German guy recommending the song. And you see that I can skip all these complete things. Yeah. This is the Bible according to Biff. It's the best friend of Jesus Christ who helps him out when he fails. Yeah, this is all the things. Yeah. And this is a German television series called Tutti Frutti, where girls are being dressed as fruits. Yeah, Tutti Frutti, all these fruits. This is not literature. You see, it fits in David Bowie, because David Bowie also relates on Little Richard, which did Tutti Frutti. Yeah, you see, but now Tutti Frutti are people, male, females, yeah, females dressing as fruits. You see, they're not dressing as animals, but they're dressing as fruits. So one further step down the ladder of God's creation. Yeah, so fruits are vegetables, are things which God made for meat. Yeah, and they have no living soul inside. So it's far more worse than a woman would dress as an animal, but if they dress as a fruit, it's even worse. Yeah, but you see, this is all futile. All these books, the Archangel Raziel, he never exists. We can skip that. This is all futile. So this is David Bowie in the actual movie Labyrinth, okay? Labyrinth. Yeah, you see, oh, here is a special... magic ball. I don't know what name it is in English. And this movie has been made, and now it's getting really nitty gritty. Yeah, Labyrinth is a 1986, and now you have, haha, finally English text. A musical dark fantasy directed by Jim Henson. You know who Jim Henson is?
Oh, rings a bell.
Yeah. Together with George Lucas. You know who George Lucas is?
Yeah, that's right. George Lucas is the...
director.
Producer, is he?
Director or producer, yeah. Producer of Star Wars.
Star Wars, thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. And Jared, the Goblin King, was portrayed by David Bowie. And most of the film's significant characters, apart from Bowie and Connolly, are played by puppets produced by Jim Henson's Creature Shop. You can imagine who Jim Henson really is?
Hmm.
Creature Shop, ring a bell? You know the Muppet Show?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, Jim Henson's Muppets.
Yeah, of course.
Manly, man-shaped puppets, or man-played puppets, Muppets. It's an art word. Yeah. So Jim Henson's Creature Shop. And in this film, the 16-year-old Sarah Williams recites from a book titled "The Labyrinth" in the park with her dog Merlin. Oh. This is a Sorcerer Merlin reference, but becomes distracted by a line she is unable to remember while being watched by a barn owl. Congratulations.
Oh, boy.
Peter Gabriel, OVO, anyone? The Owl, Lilith, Children's Sacrifice, anyone? You see, it's always the same references they are using in that films.
Mola.
The Owl is a messenger of the evil side. And the Owl is a depiction of Lilith and of Baal. Yeah, it's all about children's sacrifice here. Okay, but going on, we will take a look at Jim Henson, please. This is Jim Henson's Creature Shop. Looks familiar, but...
No. Yeah. It almost looks like a Pope's mitre upside down or something.
Yeah, but actually it looks also like OVO.
Oh, sure.
And the owl. Yeah. Huh? Yeah.
It sure does. Yeah, the owl. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. You remember Peter Gabriel, OVO?
Oh, of course, yeah.
And Drake, the rapper.
Okay.
Or the mouthpiece of Satan, so to say.
Yep.
Yeah. This is the Jim Henson's Foundation. Yeah, you see, these are the creatures you would love to meet in the real life, huh?
No, thanks.
A creature with dragon wings and a horn?
No, thanks. No, thanks.
Okay.
It's like, what was that cathedral that burned down in France?
Yeah, Notre Dame, yeah.
Notre Dame, yeah.
Yeah, correct. They have these
little
creatures.
Things up on the roof there.
Yeah, correct, correct. And this is the Jim Henson's Foundation. Yeah? Something strange on that picture here?
Yeah. The big hand.
Mm-hmm.
Shadowing the
The shadow does not is not in line with the figure, huh?
No, not
Yeah.
at all.
You see, these
No.
are three extensions here, two arms and one head, but these are five fingers. Yeah. What leaves when you delete three fingers? This finger, that finger, and this finger. Then you got the index finger and the fourth finger. Then you get the devil's.
That's so funny. Your cursor is the same hand, only white.
Sorry. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, really?
I'm actually, am I right or am I right?
Yeah. That this is all. Well, what can we call that, Michael? Would that be like, well, we have these so-called icons. This would be a way of showing you in plain sight what's going on, but not getting it. In other words, oh, that's just their logo. It's innocent. No problem. But really, they're showing you what they're really doing in your face.
Yeah, you see the two legs, and one leg is 90 degrees erased or whatever. Yeah. So, but if you see there are five fingers, but there cannot be five fingers in the shadow. So two fingers are added, and these are the fingers which makes the devil horn signs, or it can make the devil horn signs actually. Yeah. It's normally a little finger, but you can make also the horn signs or the sign of a horn by using two fingers and sparing the middle finger. And so, as you see, that's really interesting. And it's getting more interesting if you remember Queen and Muppets doing Bohemian Rhapsody. And Bohemian Rhapsody, the first line of the actual song of the introduction is "Mama, just kill the man." Yeah. So they did not sing that in that children episode of Muppet Show, but actually that people think that Bohemian Rhapsody is just a song about the coming out of being a homosexual from Freddie Mercury, which isn't. It is not true. I needed, I think, 2 sessions, 2 hours to go to that song, but I think that I know what's it all about. And you see here, this is Alice Cooper in The Muppet Show. So if you think that The Muppet Show is all innocent and you can leave your four-year-old in front of the television and go out shopping with your best friend, you're terribly wrong. Terribly wrong. So the last thing I like to do here, because we go into the stuff from David Bowie, which is coming soon, is, for example, here, Loving the Alien. It's a song of the late 80s, I think. And you see, he's always mixing everything around. He's looking here like a demon eyes, which Peter Gabriel did on his first album. He's telling here about the Templars and the Saracens. They're traveling the Holy Land. Torture comes and torture goes. Knights who'd give you everything. They bear the cross of Coeur de Lion, which is the heart of Lion, which is also Coeur de Lion is a brand from Germany making bracelets. Yeah. So I don't know if he's making a reference here of the legend of the Lionheart of King whatever of Lionheart. I cannot remember now. Cannot remember everything, or what else. But he's just mixing everything up. All your sins are hooked upon the sky. Pray and the heathen lie will disappear. Prayers, they hide the saddest view, and your prayers, they break the sky into. Yeah, believing the strangest things, loving the alien. Ah, who might that alien be? Yeah, so it's actually a waste of time to go into every song text of David Bowie. Yeah, there are far more interesting things in this David Bowie lecture, I think. Yeah, Christians and the unbelievers hanging by the cross and nail. But if you pray, all your sins are hooked upon the sky. Pray and the heathen lie will disappear. Yeah. What shall I say? I'm really sick of his mixing up of all kind of religions and thinking, professing to be wise, they became fools. Romans. It's every time the same. Yeah, you pray till the break of dawn. Yeah, this is the reference. Dawn is the code word for Lucifer. Always was, always is, always will be. Yeah. Yeah, this is a video still from Loving the Alien. You see, this is a religious position. Mm-hmm. And all these mirror images here, they speak of another dimension. This is quite so in your face, actually. And I don't have to tell anything about that picture. Yeah, and this is for the next episode. Because we have now, I think, about 1 hour. Can you confirm that, Brad?
Yes, I sure can. Yep, about that. Yep.
Okay. So that was David Bowie. And this is from the official video, David Bowie. You see here the time marker, 18 seconds and 4 minutes 25. Yeah. And he's here depicted with gray or light green, nothing healthy looking in a bed. Yeah. And this is from Bowie. Yeah, David Bowie, quite an interesting character, I think. And I hope we have made some progress in the David Bowie script in the next episode. We will go deep into David Bowie's career of acting. And this will satisfy, I hope, at least the United States audience, because we couldn't show this fragment in Germany because it was banned. It was not possible to show it there.
And video?
I was very upset. I was very upset because I had very much hard work to do all this stuff. And so I had to do for the German lecture, I had to copy every scene, about 30 scenes out of the video with subtitles and so. And I hope I can use the original video in this English lecture in the next session, Brett, so that you can really see what's it all about.
Yes. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah?
This and the next, the second to next episode. There are coming two films where David Bowie played, and then you get really, really an imagination that it is very strange that David Bowie always is casted as a kind of lunatic. It's really interesting. But before we get out of time and things are getting out of hand, let us remind you that Brad and me can only do this research and can do all these sessions by having the Bible, King James Version 1611, as our foundation, so that we measure everything that all these artists are putting out in word and pictures and symbols according to the Bible. Yeah, that's the foundation. We could not do that if we hadn't had the King James Bible in the first place, but because you have to know the truth to reveal the lie. Jesus Christ says in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one gets to the Father but by me. So no one gets to the Father except by the truth. And that's also, you see that in the ninth commandment, you shall not bear false witness. So the path, the narrow path, is the path of truth. And you know, I don't like to cite him, but I know a quote of Mark Twain, who's not actually also, of course, not a Christian, but Mark Twain is his artist name, his real name, I cannot remember at this moment. And he says a thing which was valid at his days and is valid on yet now and in the future also. And he said, according like that, I don't know the exact quote, but something like this, the lie has moved around the world three times before the truth slowly takes on her shoes.
Here we go. A lie can travel around the world and back again while the truth is lacing up its boots.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Yeah, I just quick looked it up as you were.
Yeah, great.
I was going to look up Mark Twain real name.
Here. Yeah, yeah.
I'll look up that too as long as I'm at it. But Samuel Langhorne Clemens, it says.
Yeah, okay, yeah, right, yeah. Yeah, but you see, the quote actually tells the truth. Because Satan knows he's got only but a short time. And so he has to put out the quantity of lies, quantity, so that people cannot keep up and they fall for this lie or that lie. It does not matter, but they will fall for a lie. Mankind has fallen already for a lie. And it was the first lie. You shall surely not die, was the lie. And man became mortal after that. Mankind, speaking of Adam and Eve, was flown out of the Garden of Eden and had to work hard and had to raise children and had complications and pain during the birth for the women, etc., etc. You can look that up in Genesis chapter 3 and the following. It's all based on lies. And so this complete world outside, it's not only the satanic media, but also businesses, companies, whatever. It's all based, the foundation of their
success. The merchants of the earth, yeah.
Merchants of the earth, correct. All based upon the first lie of the serpent who beguiled Eve in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to find the truth. So I would really, dear listener, I would really love to recommend the King James Version 1611. To have a biblical foundation for all the things which are coming to pass in the next time. And we are facing very interesting times in the future, in the near future. So please rely on the Almighty God, not on one God or so-called God, but on the Almighty God and His mercy, by having faith in His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, who is the truth, the way, and the life. And on that, I like to hand it over to Brett. Thank you very much.
Yes, thanks, Michael. You know, this is really, yeah, the broad way. You know, that's the satanic media agenda. It's the broad way. It's the way that everyone goes because, hey, everyone else is doing it. Should be fine, right?
Mm-hmm.
One problem. We forget about our Bibles and what it says about separating yourself from the things of the world because the love of the world is enmity to God. So, yeah. Thanks again, Michael. This has been a really interesting expose on David Bowie and the dark side of the so-called American culture, the sex, drugs, and rock and roll that has destroyed our families and our friendships and our most intimate relationships in our lifetimes. And until next time, read your Bible and Maranatha.